Hello student, in last video we discussed the colligative properties, that is elevation, boiling point, depression of freezing point. Okay, now let us discuss in-text numerical problems. So this problem number 2.7. okay, let us see what is the given here. Question: 18 grams of glucose, okay, that is formula what we have, C6H12O6, is dissolved in 1 kg of water. Okay, means here we have the 18 grams of 18 grams of glucose, it is less. So 1 kg of water is more, means it's a solute and it's a solvent. Okay, so in a sasupan, sasupan means one type of pan. Okay, next, at what temperature will water boil at 1.013 bar? Okay, they are asking the what temperature of the solution. Okay, Kb for water already given, how much we have, 0.52 Kelvin kg per mole. Okay, now let us see the data. What the given data, what the given, first the given the mass of glucose, how much we have, 18 grams per mole. Mass of solvent, how much given, 1 kg. Kb already given. Now what we have to find out, boiling point of solution. So how big, how means here asking what, after adding solute and solvent, we have after adding the solute to solvent, they're asking means here, for example, what is the given means. Okay, here we have one beaker, this is our solvent water. Okay, solvent is a water. For that, what you are adding, glucose, C6H12O6, nothing but this is our solute we are going to add. After adding this, nothing but, so what happened, one solute solvent means solution. Now at what temperature it's going to be boil? Okay, this is asking the what temperature of the solution, nothing but they are asking what TB, how much. So now if you see the relation, TB, what means here, if you go further, so here for water, here water change in boiling point, here if you go, if you further, we have relation about delta TB equal to KB into molality. Okay, but are they given molality? We don't have. Actual what we have relation, delta TB equal to KB into molality. Okay, so delta TB means what we have here, TB minus TB naught. Okay, this is relation, in equal to KB into molality. Do we have molality directly? None, it is not there. Okay, so this is the how we have to, this also we don't know. Okay, so this already given, so we have to find out the TB of the solution. This one we have to find out. So this one already given, we have to find out this one, and we should, if you know these two values, we can find out the TB. Okay, now let us see here. So our relation what we have, delta TB equal to KB into molality. Molality we don't know, but we can calculate. Why? Because means molality definition what we have, number of moles of solute by mass of solvent in kg. So here what is the solute we have, glucose, but number of moles directly doesn't given, but we can calculate. Why? Because means solute mass given. So number of moles of glucose, nothing but we have mass of glucose by molar mass of glucose. Mass of glucose, how much we have, 18 grams per mole. Okay, so 18 grams are given. Molar mass, as you know very well, 180 grams. Here how to calculate, already we discussed in case of stoichiometry also. So if you calculate, how much you are getting, 180 grams per mole. Okay, so if you substitute here, gram going to get cancer, you are going to left how much means 0.1 mole of glucose came. Okay, now molality definition what we have, number of moles of solute by mass of solvent in kg. Okay, now already solvent, already they mentioned as a 1 kg. Okay, so molality equal to 0.1 by 1 kg means how much you're getting, 0.1 mole into per kg. Why? Because means if you center go denominator, you're getting the per kg. Now let us substitute here. Now substitute all this value in this formula, delta TB equal to KB value already given, how much, that is 0.52 Kelvin kg per mole into number of moles. Molality, how much we got here, 0.1. okay, 0.1 into mole per kg. So per kg, per here, per kg, kg going to get cancelled. Okay, per mole, mole going to get cancelled. So how much you left now, delta TB equal to 0.052 Kelvin. Okay, so this is the elevation boiling point, but what they ask, only solution. Okay, as you know very well, delta TB na equal to what, TB minus TB naught. Okay, but here TB, do we have TB, where TB naught value, it is not there. But as you know very well, boiling point of water, how much we have, 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, you have to convert into Kelvin. If you add the 273, how much you are getting, 373.15. okay, 273.15, if you add, it's going to convert as a 373.15. okay, so now if you here this value, you have to remember. Okay, if water is there, you have to remember the KB value and what is the boiling point. So here already we know the boiling point of water, how much? Kelvin. Why? Because mean this value already in the Kelvin is there. So boiling point also you have taken the Kelvin. So 373.15 Kelvin. Now if you go for the simplification, if it is undergo this side, you are going to get the plus. So TB, this much value. So finally how much you are getting TB? 373.202 Kelvin. Okay, this is our TB. Now let us see here. What I want to convey means, this is our the pure solvent, nothing but water. Okay, how much you have here value? 373.15 Kelvin. Okay, after adding the non-volatile solute, the temperature increase how much? 373.202. Here how much variation is there? 373.202 Kelvin. Okay, only this much is called as our elevation boiling point. Okay, mean boiling point is increased. You should not think that okay, increase means it's going to increase 1 or 4 or 5 degrees more. It is not like that. Here how much means only 0.052 Kelvin is increased. Okay, that is called as our elevation in boiling point. Okay, very little bit changes is there, but that also we are going to count. That is called as our elevation. Means here we have the pure solvent, when you add non-volatile solute, temperature is increased. That is called as elevation in boiling point. Okay, now let us see here next problem 2.8. what we have? The boiling point of benzene is 373.23 Kelvin. Okay, boiling point of pure benzene already given. When 1.80 grams of non-volatile solute were dissolved in 90 grams of benzene, okay, the boiling point is raised to 354.11 Kelvin. See, this is a pure solvent. Okay, you are going to add some non-volatile solute, temperature from 353.23 increased to what? 354.11 Kelvin. Okay, so from here to here means this is a pure solvent, this is about the solution. Okay, now calculate the molar mass of solute. Okay, Kb for benzene 2.53 Kelvin kg per mole. So benzene, other than water, already we discussed, other than water means you have, they will give the in the data. So here we have the benzene as a solvent. So Kb value how much is given? 2.53 Kelvin kg per mole. Okay, now let us see what we have to find out. So we have to find out the molar mass of solute. So let us go for the solution. So what we have? Pure benzene. Okay, that is a TB naught. How much we have temperature? 353.23. This is a boiling point. Mass of solute how much we have? 1.80 grams. Mass of solvent benzene how much they have? 90 grams. Okay, Kb for benzene already given 2.53 Kelvin kg per mole. Okay, now we have to find out the one solution boiling point, nothing but TB we have to find. TB already given how much? 354.11 Kelvin. Okay, now what we have to find out? M2. Okay, so now if you see here, what we have relation? Delta TB equal to Kb into W2 into 1000 divided with the one M2 into W1. Okay, yeah, this is one nothing but molality only, but molality if you take the mass of solvent in the grams, you have to multiply with the 1000. Like already we discussed in case of water, if you see molality, normality, if value in liters, directly you can take, but in the ml means you have to multiply with the 1000. Here also, if mass of solvent in grams means you have to multiply with the 1000. Now delta TB first we have to find out, but we know that delta TB equal to what? TB minus TB naught. So TB already is there. Okay, TB naught already given. Okay, so here if you go for the minus, so how much we are getting? Delta TB came. So delta TB we find out. So KB already given. So W2, W1 already given. So we can find out now M2, molar mass of solute. Okay, so this one how much we got? Delta TB difference 0.88 Kelvin equal to what? This is already where we have the value into mass of solvent. How much we have? 1.8 grams into 1000 grams. Okay, this is per kg. Okay, divided with the what? M2 into 90 grams. So if you go for the simplification, we are getting the molar mass of solute M2 equal to what? 58 grams per mole. Okay, this is the, like that we can calculate the molar mass of solute by using the elevation in boiling point. Okay, now let us see the numericals based on the what? Depression in freezing point. So this is an indexed question based for what? Freezing point. Okay, depression freezing point, plot number 2.9. What is the given? 45 grams of ethylene glycol. What is the formula we have? C2H6O2 is mixed with 600 grams of water. This is a solvent, right? Because it is present in the more amount. So this is solvent and this is a solute. Okay, first question is what? Calculate the freezing point depression. So we have to find out the delta TF and the freezing point of the solution, nothing but we have to find out the only TF. Okay, so let us see the data. What is the data given? Mass of ethylene glycol, how much given? 45 grams. Mass of water, how much given? 600 grams given. Okay, I'm going to convert as about 600 kg, why? Because means we need the molarity, we need that. So 600 grams if you convert into kg means how many kg? 0.6 kg. okay, you have divided with the what? 1000. So we have to find out one delta TF, first question. Again, second question, what we have? TF, nothing but freezing point of solution we have to find out. Now let us go for the substitute. So first of all, finding out what delta TF, what we have? Delta TF equal to KF into molarity. So molarity we don't have directly, so but what we have? We have the data of we can calculate number of moles of solute. Okay, mass of solvent already given, so you can calculate the molarity. So now calculate number of moles of solute equal to mass of ethylene glycol, molar mass of ethylene glycol. Mass of already given 45 grams. Molar mass of ethylene glycol means if you calculate here, already mentioned here. So how much you are going to get? 62 grams per mole. So if you go for the simplification, we are getting the number of moles as about 0.73 moles. Now, molar differential is what? We have number of moles of ethylene glycol, mass of solvent in kg. Okay. So here how much we are getting? Already 0.73 mole came. Mass of how much? Mass of solvent 0.6 kg. So if you how much molarity, how much we are getting? 1.2 mole per kg. Okay. Now already we have the KF value already given. Molarity we calculate. Now substitute in this equation. So delta TF equal to, if you substitute these values, you are getting the how much mean? 2.2 Kelvin. Okay. Now next question, what we have? We have to find out the TF. So as you know very well, delta TF equal to TF naught minus TF. Okay. So we need the TF now. If you go for this side, TF equal to TF naught minus delta TF. So TF of here, TF naught doesn't given. But here you have to remember, freezing point of pure water, you know very well, 0 degree Celsius. Here if you convert into Kelvin, how much? 273.15 Kelvin. Okay. So you have to remember for water, as we discussed in case of delta TB. So you have to remember the boiling point of water and freezing point of water. Okay, so now how much value we have? Delta TF naught mean 273.15 Kelvin. Here delta TF, how much we got? 2.2 Kelvin. So if you go for the simplification, TF equal to 270.95. okay, now you can see here. See, already we discussed one statement, is one TF naught is more than that of the TF. Okay, how means? You can see here, this is what TF naught, okay, nothing but pure solvent. How much here we have? Freezing point 273.15 Kelvin is there. When you add the non-volatile solute, what happened? Freezing point going to be decreases. How much it came now? 270.95. See, you can see the value. 273.15, this is what? 270.95. So this is called as what? See, very, very much like, how much difference is getting? 2.2 Kelvin, okay, this much of variation is came. So this is called what? Depression in freezing point. Now let us see the problem number 2.10. What is given here? 1 gram of non-electrolyte solute dissolved in 50 grams of benzene, lower the freezing point of benzene by 0.40 Kelvin. Means here we have the, this is what? Delta TF. How much means we have? The freezing point going to decrease how much? Here we have 0.4, nothing but delta. This is the difference, okay? 0.4. KF for benzene already given. How much? 5.12 Kelvin kg per mole, okay? Now find out the molar mass of solute. Again, we have to find out the what? Molar mass of solute. Now let us see the solution. So data what is given? Delta TF, how much we have? Difference 0.40, okay?
Mama.
Mass of solute, how much we have? 1 gram, okay? Mass of solvent, how much we have here? Mass of solvent, how much we have? 50 grams. So molar mass of solute we have to find out. Here we have direct relation. When the solvent weight given in the what grams means, you can take directly 1000 here, okay? Delta TF equal to KF into W2 into 1000 divided with the M2 into W1. So we have to find out the molar mass of solute. Now delta TF, how much we have? 0.4 Kelvin, okay? KF value already given. This is what? 5.12 Kelvin kg per mole, okay? Into mass of solute, how much we have? 1 gram into 1000. This is what? 1000 gram per kg, okay? How you are taking 1000 gram per kg? This is how to write, otherwise it's not going to cancel. Divide with the what? M2 we have to find out. Mass of solvent already given 50 grams. So grams are gram going to get cancelled. Sorry, this gram going to get cancelled. Kg per kg going to get cancelled. So Kelvin, Kelvin going to get cancer. So he left with the molar mass of solute how much? 256 gram per mole. Okay, this is a application of colligative property. By using the depression freezing point, you can calculate the molar mass of solute. Okay. So if you see the next in the textbook, we have the two relation to find out the Kb and Kf. Okay. So in the textbook given the two relation to find out the Kb and Kf. Okay. Here every time we are taking the Kb Kf directly. Okay. If someone want to calculate Kb Kf, how we have to calculate mean by using the following formula. Let us see here. The values of Kb and Kf which depends upon the nature of solvent. Okay, very very important. Okay, first class itself depends the colligative, what we told, colligative properties depends on the number of solute particles. Okay, now but again nature of solvent also, how, because means Kb Kf depends on the what, nature of solvent. Already we told here, we done the problems for Kf for water is different, Kb value for water and benzene different. Okay, so how you are going to calculate Kf equal to what we have formula, Kf equal to R into M1 into Tf square divided with the what, 1000 into delta H of fusion. Okay, enthalpy of fusion. Already we discussed in case of what, this is an enthalpy of fusion in the thermodynamics. Okay, next to Kb equal to what, R into M1 into Tb square divided with the 1000 into delta H. This is called the enthalpy of vaporization. Already we discussed in case of thermodynamics. So here where R means what, universal gas constant. Okay, M1 means what, molar mass of solvent. You should be very careful, this is a molar mass of solvent. Tf means what, freezing point of pure solvent in Kelvin. You have taken the Kelvin only, why, because means R units will be in the Kelvin. Tb means what, boiling point of pure solvent, that is also in the Kelvin. Now delta Hf means what, enthalpy for the fusion of the solvent. Delta H vaporization means what, enthalpy of vaporization of solvent. Okay, based on this numericals we don't have, but we once someone if want to calculate the Kf Kb means, you can take the these formulas. With these formulas you can calculate the Kf and Kb. Okay.